Good morning, students. In this today's video of oil hydraulics and pneumatics, we will see regarding the industrial circuit. Before we move to the topics in this video, let us recall we have seen two different circuits in our previous video, that is meter in and meter out. What is meter in circuit? Meter in circuit is a circuit which is used to control the speed of the extracting cylinder, as well as meter out circuit is a circuit which is used to control the speed of the retracting actuator. So whenever we require the speed control, we go for the meter in or meter out circuit. Now in this today's video, we will see regarding the fail safe circuit and the power loss in the hydraulic system. Now what is this fail safe circuit? Fail safe circuit is a circuit which is used for the prevention or hazardous or uncertain things to be happened. So when there is an emergency or when there is the operation which we don't require, in that case automatically the system should stop. So it is very important that fail or safe circuit is playing very important role during an emergency or overloading of the system or any wrong operation done by the operator. As well as we will go through some brief regarding the power loss in the hydraulic system, where the power loss occurs and how it takes place. Now, fail-safe circuit, what is the main importance of this circuit? Fail-safe circuit are those designed to prevent injury to the operator or damage to the equipment. It means during the operation, if there is any mishappening, so this circuit are designed in such a way that if there is a mishappening or any mistake done by the operator or any hazardous thing, it will prevent the injury. It will work as a safety of the system. In general, they prevent the system from accidentally failing on an operator and also prevent overloading of the system. So mainly there are two type of circuit. The first one is which prevents the adherent or inoperative step by the operator, and the second one is preventing the overload of the circuit. Sometime the circuit gets overloaded and it is out of the control of the operator, but system is such foolproof designed that the overloading will divert and prevent the overloading. Now in following section, we shall discuss two fail-safe circuit. So there are two fail-safe circuit. The first one is protection from inadvertent cylinder extension. Suppose the cylinder is extending, is not extending as per our requirement. In that case, this particular circuit will come into the action and it will prevent the inadvertent. That is, inadvertent means the thing which we, the unnecessary or unwanted cylinder extension. And the second one is the overload protection. Circuit is getting sometime overloaded, then it will prevent the overloading of the circuit. Circuit is getting overloaded, it will divert the fluid, and in that situation it will prevent the overloading. Now let us see the protection from inadvertent cylinder extension in the next slide. Okay, now this is the circuit. Here one by one we will see the components. This is the power pack of the system. Here you can see in the construction, this is the reservoir, this is the pump attached with the motor, and this is the pressure regulator unit, this is the return to the tank, this is the pressure gauge. So this is the common unit which is used, you can say, the power pack unit commonly used in the circuit. Other than this, you can see here is a two-way, three-way, three-port direction control valve. This is the two-way, four-port direction control valve which is used here. Then the next one is check valve, which is used here. The main function of check valve is to allow only one direction flow. This is the actuator, as we all know, the two-way actuator. Now, how this circuit is working? Here you can see inadvertent extension. It means while extension, when it is moving down, just let us see the construction of this circuit. On the piston rod side, a check valve is given. This check valve is connected to the pressure gauge, and one drain line is connected to the inlet of the piston side. Two-way direction control valve is there, and here a bypass other two-way three-port valve is there. This is the two-way three-port, one, two, and three-port valve is there. Now, this is the entire layout of the protection from inadvertent circuit extension. Now, for example, when the cylinder is extending, suppose we need to stop the extension of this, in that case the check valve will come into the action, and whatever the pressure is generated, it will lift this ball valve and it will avoid the extension of this. Now let us in next slide we will see the working of this, how it is working. Now from figure it shows that a fail-safe circuit is designed to prevent the cylinder from accidentally falling in an event when a hydraulic line ruptures or a person inadvertently operate the manual override on the pilot actuated direction control valve when the pump is not working. For example, when pump is not working, in that case if the line ruptures or a person inadvertently, unwantedly, it operates the manual override, in that case the pilot actuated or direction control valve or this circuit of protection from inadvertent cylinder extension will come into the action. To lower the cylinder, pilot pressure from the blank end of the piston must open the check valve to allow oil to return through the direction control valve. What does it mean? In the previous slide we have seen, to lower the cylinder, pilot pressure from the blank end of the piston must open the check valve to allow oil to return through the direction control valve. It means, I'll just show you friends. So you can see here, this is the blank side of the piston, and here check valve is there. So suppose pump is not working, in order to allow this to drop this piston, sometime what happens, suppose pump is not working and whatever the pressure is generated here, it will not allow the piston to drop. So in order to drop this, the check valve should be operated so that whatever the oil is there, it will drain through this to the reservoir. So you can see here, in order to lower the cylinder. Next is, this happens when the push button is actuated to permit the pilot pressure actuation of the direction control valve, or when the direction control valve is directly or manually actuated when the pumps operate. It means as soon as the pump operate, there is as I shown you in figure, three port, two-way three-port valve is actuated, and that operates the direction control valve, which is directly or manually actuated when the pump operates. So this will release the fluid from piston rod side and allow the fluid to flow through it, and it will avoid the inadvertent extension of the cylinder. The pilot operated direction control valve allows free flow in the opposite direction to retract the cylinder when this direction control valve returns to its offset mode. During the retract mode, there is a free flow. Free flow means no pressure is generated. Whatever the pressure is generated by the pump, it is directly returning to the reservoir. So it becomes free flow, and whatever the pressure, little bit it is generated, it will retract the piston on the upward direction. So this will allow the retraction of the cylinder in spite of the flow through the direction control valve of the system. So this is how the circuit works, and this is how the inadvertent cylinder extension is prevented by this circuit. Now the next one is fail-safe system with overload protection. This is this kind of incidents oftenly happen. इस तरह के incident commonly ज़्यादातर देखने को मिलते हैं कि अगर system overload होता है. For example, in our pressure cooker also, at home we have seen the pressure cooker. So in pressure cooker, in spite of the safety valve, there is one more fusion plug provided. अगर आप प्रेशर कुकर को देखोगे तो ऊपर सेफ्टी वाल तो है ही, डेड वेट वाल, उसके अलावा एक ढक्कन के ऊपर एक फ्यूज़न प्लग दिया होता है, दैट इफ सर्टेन लिमिट एक्सटेंड्स द फ्यूज़न वाल शुड द फ्यूज़न प्लग शुड कम इन टू एक्शन एंड रिलीज द प्रेशर, एंड दैट इज द ओवर प्रेशर ऑफ द जनरेशन इन द प्रेशर कुकर. तो सिमिलर ओवरलोड प्रोटेक्शन सर्किट इज प्रोवाइडेड हियर. फर्स्ट लेट अस सी वन बाय वन द कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ दिस. दिस इज द पावर पैक. As I told you, the pressure regulator valve, PRV valve, pressure gauge, pump, motor, reservoir. These are the reservoirs. So the common power pack setup. Now from that, here you can see, if you see clearly, this is the V1, that is direction control valve 1. This is V2, this is the direction control valve 2, this is V3, direction control valve 3, and this is V4, that is direction control valve 4. This is the check valve. So this is it is a three-way four port direction control valve. You can make correction here, it is a three-way four port direction control valve. This is the check valve and this is the actuator. Along with that, you can see this is single way two port, this is two port, two way two port, this is two way three port, and this is two way four port direction control valve. So these are the valves which are being operated here. Now how this come into the action? So let us see here. For example, during the extraction stroke, when the force is being extracted, or during the extraction stroke, if there is an overload which is not being beared by the pump, in that case the flow takes place in this direction and flow is flowing through this. So the flow is flowing through V1. As soon as the overload, it means the flow restricts here, flow aage jana band kar dega, agar piston aadhe tak pahuncha hai aur overload ho raha hai aur yahan se pressure jo bhi generate ho raha hai wo yahan develop nahi ho pa raha ya excess develop ho raha hai, in that case the valve, you can see here, the valve 1, sorry, the V4, which is there, it is in the connection. So whatever the excess pressure is generated, it will divert the flow to the reservoir. So when valve 1 is overloaded, it will divert the flow or to the reservoir. It will bypass to the reservoir, or else it will send the signal to V3, and that V3 will come into the actuation and it will bypass the flow. Similarly, during the retraction, suppose the retraction, the pressure is, it is being overloaded. So whatever the pressure it is developed on the check valve. As soon as the check valve limits comes, it will divert the flow to the V4 through this connection. You can see the dotted connection is there, and that will send the pulse to the V4, and V4 will operate V1 direction valve, and this V1 direction valve will release the pressure, and the whatever the fluid, excess fluid is generated, it will transfer to the bypass. So this is the construction. Let us see the descriptive part once again. So in the figure we have seen that fail-safe system that provides overload protection for system component. The direction control valve V1 is controlled by the push button three-way valve V2. So if there is the direction control valve is operated with the help of V2. When the overload valve V3 is in its spring offset mode, it drains the pilot line of the valve 1. I told you pilot valve 1 will, that which is at the extraction, at the top portion, it will drain the fluid and return to with the help of V3, it will return it. If the cylinder experiences excessive resistance during the extraction stroke, sequence valve V4 pilot actuates overload valve V3. So I told you the valve which is you can see here. So the V3 valve which is provided here through the bypass of this, this is the sequence valve of that, it will come into the action and it will return the return the flow to the reservoir. So friends, this is the circuit for overloading. The next is the drain of the pilot line of valve 1 causing to return to its spring offset mode. All these valves are spring offset mode, so easily as the pressure is generated, it can revert it automatically with the help of the spring pressure or the manually operation. If a person then operates the push button valve V2, nothing happens unless overload valve V3 is manually shifted into the block port configuration. So once the overload circuit comes into the action, manually we have to, in order to bring to the original position, manually we have to push it for its original workout. Thus the system components are protected against excessive pressure due to an excessive cylinder load during its extension stroke. So this is how the fail-safe system or overload protection circuit is designed. Friends, some companies design based on their own requirement, on their space availability, and nowadays it is slowly everything is going to be digitalized. So the because of the digitalization and automation, overload as well as inadvertent working of the operator is very foolproof, because the safety is a prior or the first parameter to be taken into the consideration while designing any circuit. So along with the circuit design, the safety parameters also are very important in order to understand how we can arrange or manage the overloading or inadherent working of the system. So friends, there are many different arrangement of the systems that you can see. Different many systems are there. So depending on the requirement, depending on the design criteria, depending on the availability, space availability, this design slightly varies. It is not that. So this is just an idea of constructing the circuit. Now the next point is power loss in the hydraulic system. Friends, you know the rules for the energy conservation. Energy can neither be destroyed nor created. So one form of energy is converted to another form. In IC engine we have seen only 40 or 50% of 30 to 50 or 60% of efficiency is obtained. Rest of the thing losses are there. Similarly, losses are there in the hydraulic system also. So let us see one by one. Normally the efficiency of hydraulic system is around 40 to 60%. Beyond that, some losses are there, the friction losses, flow losses, heat generation losses. So different types of losses are there. Now the power loss in lines are due to the friction and flow deflection. This is the major reason for the power loss in any hydraulic system. The fluid which we are using, it has some own viscosity. The pipes which we are using, the internal surface of the pipe, it has its own friction. Valves, pressure regulating valve, all these devices generates some friction, even also the change in the flow direction. So these are the two major points which generates the power loss, or which are the reason for the power loss for an hydraulic system. The first one is friction and second is the flow deflection. Power loss in valve as well as accessories such as filter and coolers are also the reason which restrict the flow. And as it restrict the flow, the back pressure is generated, and it will that back pressure is generated on the pump side, or if the depending on the location of the filter, the strainer or meshing which is there, it will restrict or it will not allow to flow free flow. So there are some losses due to the accessories also in the system. Power losses occurs due to the throttling. Suppose we are controlling the flow rate by increasing or decreasing, also results into the power loss of the system. The power loss occurs due to the throttling, which on constant pressure systems are particularly high. For example, when the pump is generating a constant pressure and we are throttling, we are reducing or increasing the flow rate. Of course, in cylinder, when cylinder is extracting, initially when there is a momentum to from zero to increase the velocity of the actuator, the somewhat pressure is generated. Thereafter it reaches to the maximum, and there again it becomes zero. When it is reverting, all the conditions changes, the flow direction changes, but the pressure which is generated, it is constant. So because of that also, the throttling process, increasing or decreasing of the speed of the or flow rate, increasing or decreasing the flow rate results to the power loss. Power loss because of the leakage in the system, and to avoid it must be sealed. Friends, the leakage in the system also is one of the reason for the power loss in the system. So if you see, these are the major reasons for the power loss. Along with that, the poor quality of the oil or the temperature of the fluid, excess cold temperature, excess high temperature, or some clogging of the system are also some of the reason other than the power loss or other than the these reasons which you are seeing in your slide. So there are lot of reasons for the power loss. The important thing is that we have to avoid the power loss, because if we don't stop or we don't minimize this power loss, the operating cost of the system increases, and as the operating cost increases, the net gain output profit of the system decreases. So it is very important to regularly maintain or regularly change the filter, regularly monitor the power output or pressure generated of the system, so that we can minimize the power loss, and this power will minimizing the power loss will reduce the operating cost of the system. So regular maintenance, regular filter change, regular maintaining the temperature of the working fluid are some of the key points, or maintaining, avoiding the leakages or blocking the, clearing the leakages are some of the important points which are used to avoid the power loss. So friends, once again, thank you very much for watching this video. I request you all to subscribe our channel, SSIT.Gandhinagar. Thank you. Thank you.